Yo, what is up, my crazy subscriber? This is JoeKingJohn64, and welcome to more Madden 15 Ultimate Team. Today, we're going to be playing game number 8 of Season 3. Now, this game, I'm just going to say that it's more action-packed compared to my previous 5 games that I've seen. Because my previous 5 games, you pretty much known that I've blown out every single guy. And my running attack was beast, my passing game was pretty much okay, my defense was owning. But this game, this guy gave me a challenge. And I'm not going to spoil it, so I want you guys to keep your eyes on the screen. I'm going to say that his team, the only player that stood out was Andrew Luck and his offensive lineman. He was doing a hell of a job on that. There was this one play where he actually got me pretty good. He ended up running like around 50 yards on one play. It was just insane what this guy was putting out. But at the end, you know, god damn it, it all comes down to the end. All I'm going to say is it's just going to come down to the end. That's all I'm going to say. In my first offensive drive, I kind of screwed up because I was kind of cold. I really didn't warm up before this game. I usually warm up, you know, by going solo challenge, just messing around and trying to call in my scheme and get ready to call in my scheme on real games. And this time I didn't do it. I just went straight into a game. So I can kind of say that I screwed up right here, and it could have cost me the game. And that was all on me, though. My team, it wasn't on my team. It was all on me because, you know, mentally and, you know, you got to be prepared for these kinds of games, and I didn't prepare myself, so I was just going out there cold. Meanwhile, my defense was doing a hell of a job. My defensive linemen were reacting towards Andrew Luck's, you know, play action rollouts and trying to scramble out tight. DeMontre Moore just got 4 sacks throughout the whole game, which was amazing. And by the way, guys, keep your eyes on the screen. Watch this play. CJ Spiller on the kick return, a little bit of a juke to the left, taking it all the way for 90 yards, all the way. CJ Spiller. Look at that speed. Just amazing. I recommend to put this guy as a kick returner, man. This guy doesn't cost a lot, I believe. I think he costs like around 1,000 coins, so you guys can afford him. I suggest to put him as a kick returner, and he will be like one of the best kick returners you'll ever pick up, because that's already the second time it happens. So, and by the way, he has like around 96 speed and 95 acceleration. I don't know how fast he is, but I know he's one of the fastest guys out there. And watch this one, this defensive play. Freaking Ahmad Brooks, 81 overall linebacker, knocks the shit out of the freaking receiver. That was just insane, man. How can this 81 linebacker be better than any of the elites out there that haven't even forced a fumble for me? It's just insane. Except for Luke Kuechly, though. Luke Kuechly is still a good zone defensive player, so that guy keeps his name. But the rest of the guys, come on, man. This guy's 81 overall. So I ended up back in offense, you know, rolling the ball, trying to pass as much as possible because my running game is not working. This is the first ever my running game gets shut down, you know. And for the previous few games, guys, you guys have witnessed Marshawn Lynch and Doug Martin doing their thing, and this time it wasn't happening. Right there, I screwed up majorly, and damn, that could have really, actually, it really cost me that drive. That shouldn't have happened. So this guy ended up running out some more, and DeMontre Moore still stopping Andrew Luck. Trying to run a little bit right there. It's not going to happen. That's like in the first 3 quarters, nothing happened for him in the offense. I mean, it was all luckiness. As you can see, right there, I got a little bit tongue twisted. As you can see, he took it all the way with William the Fridge Perry. Ah, what a coincidence. You know, that guy is known by that, and he actually ended up taking it all the way. So, god damn it. That was like one of the most embarrassing times that I've ever gone here in Ultimate Team. DT taking it all the way. I mean, come on, man. Because nobody was open. Like, literally, on that offensive play, nobody was freaking open. I just couldn't throw it to anyone. I wasn't going to force it and throw it under the pick. So, I ended up fumbling the ball. And right here, a great defensive stop. It was, you know, I give props to my whole D-line doing a good job right there with Haloti Ngata and DeMontre Moore. Those were the only ones doing something. Back in offense, 3rd and 1, my run gets stopped. So, I ended up doing a field goal. And now the score is 10-9. The only reason why this guy has 9 points, because he keeps going for 2-point conversions. That's the reason why he has 9 points. So I ended up back on defense. And, you know, it was his fault for going for 2 points. So now he's down by 1. He scrambles there with Andrew Luck. But actually, I have my defensemen containing. I don't understand why they're not containing. And again, he does it again. Now down the middle. So I was thinking, like, all right, let me put Haloti Ngata as a quarterback spy, as you can see. Now I'm only blitzing 3 defensive linemen. And now I leave somebody open down the middle. I'm like, god damn it. He's like reading my defense like hardcore. Throws it towards the outside. And I'm like, damn, this guy's going to score. I should just let him score right there. So I was trying my best to cover that tight end. But my linebacker just couldn't keep up. Back on offense. 2 minutes to go. Darrell Young open towards the flats. Trying to trying to get some yards before the 2 minute mark. 1 minute and 54 seconds to go. Back on offense, Jason Marr with the lucky catch. That one could have been intercepted. That was a really risky pass. It really was. It really, I was like, damn, almost gave me a heart attack. Back on offense, a little bit of play action, the single back, and nice catch by Jamichael Finley. I felt that I scored way too early, so now it leaves this guy for one more drive, and I know how this offense operates, and this guy's no matter what, he's not going to struggle on this one. I know this guy. So ended up backing off, I'm back on defense, and he ended up running that long play that I mentioned earlier. That was his only best play that Hayward ran the whole game. He ends up scrambling a little bit with Andrew Luck. Nothing happened when we end up going into overtime after that field goal. He thought he was going to win, but you know, if you do the math, we were like 3 points apart. So 18-18, back on defense, sacked with DeMontre Moore. He wasn't going to go anywhere. I wasn't going to let him scramble. Andrew Luck ain't going nowhere. 4th and 15, tries to go for an interception by Carl Harris Jr., the guy from the Broncos. Takes it for 30 yards, 20 yards, actually 25 yards, so 25 yards, and it was just a nice interception. That just gave me the game. And all I had to do was just do a field goal or just run the time and just run it down the middle. My running game just wasn't there this game, guys. I'm just going to admit that. My running game was dead this game. It was all about defensive luck this game, because whoever stopped each other was going to win. Whoever stopped who, like, that person was going to win. And my defense kind of dominated after I stopped Andrew Luck a few times, you know. So that pretty much gives me, like, the look of the winner. But anyways, this guy was a hell of an opponent, you know. Pretty much exposed my defense a few times. My offense, you know, was shut down in the running game. So I had to throw in some lucky few passes with Jason Morrow. So, you know, I got to look out with this guys, you know. I got to upgrade my tight end units because I feel like they're not blocking for me every time I run towards the outsides on the single backs and the I formation. So I'm looking to pick up in the future Mercedes Lewis and Vernon Davis. These two guys have good run blocking, so I'm thinking of replacing two tight ends, Jamichael Finley and Jason Morrow, because I do run with two tight ends at a time sometimes and some points of the game. So anyways, that's the end of the game, guys. If you guys enjoyed it, if you guys enjoyed some certain part of the video, please let me know in the comment section. Also, if you guys enjoyed the series, make sure you support it by leaving a like on the video, and I'll do some more because I know these are fun. I feel like I'm having fun doing these kinds of videos because Madden is my thing, you know. I'm having fun. No matter how hard it is, how easy it is, I'm having fun. No matter if I lose, I'm still having fun because I think it's a great game, man. This has been better than the previous Maddens. So that's it, guys. If you guys want to see more Madden 15 Ultimate Team, make sure you subscribe for more.